I'm here in the order cube with Rogier. Could you just put up your badge?
Roger Burger.
Roger, sorry. Roger, go ahead, introduce yourself.
Alright, I'm Roger Burger and I attend the Stockholm Junior Water Prize with a complete new wastewater treatment concept.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we face four crises: an energy crisis, our natural resources are coming to an end. We have climate change and we have an economical meltdown. So these are all serious things and we will have to change. We are at a defining point in history. Yeah, we will have to change. We have to make a real plan. In the water sector, that means we have an awful lot of work to do. Today, we're spilling loads of energy. We waste valuable materials, we have a massive footprint, mm-hmm. and its costs are sky high.
Mm-hmm.
So, my concept is a solution for all these crises in the water sector. Let me explain
idea. A nice flyer, you can see it quite.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Well, you collect wastewater flows separately. So you have grey water, you have black water, and you have rainwater. Grey water is often warm. You treat it in the house to keep its heat in the house. So with a flocculation unit and an algae bioreactor, you treat it, and thereafter, with a heat exchanger, you recover its heat. 25% of household energy consumption today is put into heating water. Today it just flows into a sewer and all heat is lost in no time.
And this way you can reuse it.
So now with this installation you can reuse your heat and you recover your water again. So you don't need to transport your big grey water flow anymore. Black water you collect for more houses like a district or village. And with a small local wastewater treatment plant and a USB reactor, you create biogas from the organic matter. So you create energy. Again, an algae bioreactor is applied to treat the water, and that leaves in this case a very usable fertilizer. The water is then dischargeable, but when you want to adapt to different regulations, you want it to be flexible, you add a membrane. Rainwater from streets runoff couldn't also be treated by that membrane. The sludge from the USB reactor, which is a very little amount, is treated by worms, which can reduce its volume by 75%, and at the same time they recover nutrients and metals from the sludge and they turn it into a fertilizer. The sludge remaining after the treatment of the worms is then so concentrated that might be even possible to recover medicines from the sludge. Today, sludge is concentrated and pressed with many installations, and after they've put a lot of energy in it, they burn it or discharge it. So a waste of material.
Yeah, and this recovers that as well. So it recovers basically everything, the system, everything that's in is recovered. That's the system.
This installation eliminates transport, it recovers and creates energy, you recover and create raw material as well, and it's very flexible and it makes only use of natural processes. And it's worldwide applicable, so you can use it everywhere.
Sounds very logical to me. I'm sold. So I wish you all luck, and maybe hopefully you'll win an award, which could take this. If you win the award, you do get some prize money, I've heard. Or something.
Yeah, that's right.
And then you can develop maybe the technology further.
Yeah, I get $5,000, so that will be very useful for further research. And I also hope I can find companies here that will support me in setting up a pilot scale plant to realize this idea.
This dream. Roger, thank you very much. Very inspiring. I wish you all the luck.
Thank you very much.